Okay. Municipalities. So now we are coming to the municipalities, which has been bought as another local body in 74th Constitutional Amendment Act in 1993. So don't forget the number and don't confuse with the number with the panchayat. Panchayat, it is 23rd and it is in 24th in case of municipalities, and it belongs to the part 9A of the Constitution. Okay, don't mess up with the panchayat. Panchayat is part 9 and it is part 9A. So every state, being a state of this country, every state shall constitute these municipalities. And see, there are three types of municipalities. For example, one is Nagara Panchayat, and is Municipal Council and Municipal Corporation. See, if it is a city, okay, if it is city, it is urban, the limits to pertain to the city, this is urban. And there is something called as rural. Think it is Bangalore urban and this is Bangalore rural. So there will be a transition phase, means the urban and the rural, in between these two there will be a transition phase. So this transition is called as rural. Urban plus rural is equal to rural. So for this rural we give a municipality called as Nagar Panchayat. Okay, clear with the Nagar Panchayat. And for the smaller urban area, if think it is a, there is some smaller district here, small district, for this we give a municipal council. And for larger cities, for larger urban areas like Bangalore and all, we give a corporation, municipal corporation. So I think you got the three types of municipalities, that is Nagar Panchayat and Municipal Council and Municipal Corporation. Okay, see, something, there is a term in this, the definition of cities, that is called as metropolitan area. You need to know the definition of this metropolitan area. Think if this is a city, if it's a huge city like Bangalore, fine. If it's a huge city like Bangalore, if the population of the city is more than 10 lakh, the city population itself is more than 10 lakh, then we call this city called as metropolitan area. And sometimes this metropolitan area can comprises more than one district also, can be of more than one district also. At that time only one municipal corporation will not be there. The two or three, instead of one municipal corporation, there will be two or more municipalities, and also some few panchayats are also added to it. Mean metropolitan area is such a huge area which has got more than 10 lakh population and also comprises of two or one or more district or two or more municipalities, and also it can have some panchayats also. So this is regarding this municipalities. Okay, you got, and I think you have understood the definition of metropolitan area. Fine. When it comes to the election, see, the elections, the contestants will be chosen directly from the territorial constitutions. Means if it is a city, city has got more territorial constitutions. Like this is one territorial, second territorial constituency, third territorial constituency. Like panchayat only, the elected candidate will be from that particular constituency itself. Like the candidate one, candidate two and candidate three, these candidates are getting elected from this territorial constituency itself. So these territorial constituency are called as wards. I think you are very familiar with the words. If you have visited the cities, there will be election, municipal election, and where the members for each ward will get elected from each and every area. So these wards or this territorial constituency is same being taken as per the proportional representation system. Means the territory gets selected based upon the population it has and number divided by number of seats. Depending upon the population and number of seats, the allocation of the territorial constituency gets selected, and the elections will be held from each territorial constituency. I mean, that is called as wards. And you get, okay, and sometime also these wards, like if for example these wards, think there are so many wards, ward 1, ward 2, ward 3. So think that so many wards.
So what happens, these wards, two or three wards, as per the depending upon the population, joined together to form a ward committees. Ward committees. I think you have understood the ward, the term ward also, and ward committees also. So two or three wards come together to form a ward committee, and finally after the municipality election and after the panchayat election, there is something called as district planning committee. So before that, even for the election of this municipal council, it is taken up by the state election commission only. As per panchayat election, the election responsibility, the superintendence of the election, the direction and control and preparation of the electoral rolls and conduct of all the election for the municipalities as well as panchayat. Remember this fact again, for the municipalities and panchayats, the election is conducted by election state election commission. But in case of Lok Sabha election and Vidhan Sabha election, the election is conducted by the National Election Commission. So I think you are familiar with all the thing. As I said about the ward committee also. And also, if you take the district planning committee, see finally what happens, panchayat election will be over and the elected members will get selected, and also the municipal election will be over. So after finally the members of the panchayat and members of the municipality come together to a meeting to plan a draft for the district. Means here the entire preparation of the draft development of the district for the whole actually. So it plans what the district needs and what are the infrastructure it needs, what are the development activities it can take. So for the decision making committee, for the decision making activities, the members from this panchayat and the members from this municipalities come together to a district planning commission. So district planning committee consists of panchayat and municipality both, where the fifth, if there is fourth out of fifth option, will be only the elected members of this particular, and other 1% will be some officers which is related to the district planning committee. So here the plans which they bring are consolidated together and they are discussed and they are put on into draft to discuss about the development activities of a particular district. So for the planning committee, the planning which the district has to make is made by the panchayats and municipalities as well as the some of the officers, but most of the four of the fifth part of the members will be from the panchayat and municipality who are elected by the direct elections, that is municipalities and panchayat elections. I think you are clear with the municipality also. So here the municipalities and the representation, how much municipality has to represent plus how much the panchayat has to represent in the district planning commission, that is decided by the proportional representation system. Means depending upon the population, the representation will be given for the panchayats and municipalities. Okay, I think you are clear with the same happens with the Metropolitan Planning Commission. Here the districts which are represented, the panchayats which are represented, they come together to the district planning committee or metropolitan. In case of Metropolitan Committee, it is Metropolitan Committee. They come together and they take decisions and they make the draft plan, and here also the elected members will come, four or fifth will be the elected members, and the number of the representation will be based on the proportional representation. That means as per the population, the people are getting represented in the district planning committee. Okay, here the finance commission, again the finance commission will review the report the finance commission makes a report after once the election gets over, after the municipal gets election over, and the entire report is submitted to the governor, and the governor will look into the report and this finance commission will make into some recommendation, so that this will be the financial position of the municipality. Some more extra fund is required between the state which goes between the state and municipalities, and also from the Consolidated Fund of India. It is the same procedure which is repeated in the panchayats, where the finance commission reviews the document, the report of the municipalities where and finance commission is formed by the governor, and finance commission also specifies the financial position of the municipalities, and it states how much distribution has to be done between state and the municipalities, and how much distribution, how much money has to be given from the consolidated fund of India, like same as like in the panchayat. There is no difference between the finance commission role in case of panchayats or municipalities. It is one and the same. So just the thing difference, it is the remember the fact that it is 73rd constitutional amendment, some constitutional amendment act in the case of panchayat, and 74 in case of municipalities, and it is part 9 and it is part 9A. So remember this much. And also the exceptions to the panchayat with article 244 becomes very important, because that article 244 speaks about scheduled areas where the empowerment of Gram Sabha is given in a special way, that is through the Paisa Act. Okay, this is regarding local government. So if you have any doubts, you can post the doubts below. Thank you. Thank you one and all.